Welcome to Guatemala, a country full of changes. We all have changed many things about ourselves when we were in Guatemala. Our language, the way we ate, the way we slept, many things. And one of the main things was our diet. We went from hamburgers and hot dogs, mac and cheese, to beans and tortillas for almost every meal that we had. Most of our stuff was bought from little stores called tiendas that were found throughout the cities and towns that we were in. Women were often found carrying most of the fruits and vegetables from one store to their home. Many trees were also out there with fruits, plantains, bananas, oranges, and some people even saw some lime trees. We knew that the stuff was fresh because we often saw women grinding it. Here's where we had fresh tomatoes cut for our pizza that we had made. Another hard change for me was changing from football to football. I never played soccer before, only just to jack around with my friends, but when I was here I thought I might as well take the opportunity to play with these little kids and see what it would be like and see if I could fare with them. Not only did I play, but Dr. Parsons got in the action as well. He was often found playing with us and with the little kids and hanging out with us. Another unlikely suspect that I thought was playing was Leah. Leah was out there playing soccer with the best of us. She was doing pretty good, better than I thought she would, and a lot better than the community thought she was. And this showed, when she got done playing, all the little girls came flocking to her like she was some type of superhero, and they loved it. Another change was the change in language. We all had to try to communicate with our families, and not many of us knew Spanish, or Zutuyo, or Ishio. Luckily, I knew a little bit of Spanish, so I could at least communicate with my family to try to get my point across. Although we did go to Catholic Mass in Spanish, it was hard for me to understand everything because I just spoke too fast. But when we were at the Catholic Mass, it was a lot of fun. I enjoyed the experience. It's something I'll never be able to get to do again in my life. And it was different because they actually had a funeral there, and usually that's not like it is here in the States, but it was wonderful and I loved the experience. Another type of change was a change in transportation. Our first exposure to this was when we got picked up at the airport by Raul in this minibus. Our second type was by a passenger boat, which picked us up at the docks and took us across Lake Atitlan. Another form was when we were riding in the back of a pickup truck, all 18 of us. Here's a picture where you can see many people riding around in it, as well as a tuk-tuk, which is another common form of transportation here. Men were often seen riding mules to work. Another type of common transportation is these buses, like I said, but people often sit on top. I was one of the lucky ones, too. Here we fit 23 people in our car, and here you can see the traffic and how busy and how crowded the streets are here. Another change that we all had difficulty adjusting to was the change in housing and the sleeping arrangements. Here's a picture from Samia, which weren't too bad sleeping, and here's a picture from the fourth floor window of the balcony. Our first housing adjustment was living in the mountains next to all these people with all these roosters and crowing in the middle of the night. Our next one in San Felipe was even more rough, with more people, crowdedness, dogs barking, just really rough, and we were all sleeping on wood. So when we did get a chance to sleep, we managed to sleep wherever we could, whenever we could. And here's a picture that I snapped a few of our friends getting a nap in whenever they could. I even snagged a picture of Dr. Parsons. Another type of change was the change in security. When we were in Guatemala City, we often saw guards outside of buildings with loaded shotguns. And this is to beef up security for their own businesses. And a lot of these guards were never even properly trained on how to use them. It's ironic that the police can't carry weapons, but they can. Also while driving, we often saw many armed forces at many different towns. Another type of insecurity would be during the rainy season is this mudslide that happened when we were driving up the mountains. One point when I felt touched about insecurity was when we were at the Peace Park, and you could just kind of feel the presence of those 13 people that were shot there. And along with that, you got a feel of how bad hurricanes and everything with the flooding, because you can clearly see the mud line on this hospital that was never been reopened. Here, this lady, her husband was shot in their own store, and she was left to raise her three children. Here's Baltazar, my host my second host family, and here he's talking about Enel and the water dam and how they just want 20% of their profits, and Enel is not agreeing with them because they don't want to share any part of the profits. So he's explaining how his constant struggle with that and how it's changing everything around him. Although Guatemala is known for its violence, many of us saw past that and were able to make friends with our classmates, but also the people of Guatemala. Here in Samia, we gave pots and pans to the women there, and they loved them. Even though it was a small gift for us, it was a huge gift to them. And they often wanted to take pictures of our new friends, and we took pictures of them, and they took pictures of us. So here's a few pictures that they took of us while we were here in Samia. So more of my new friends are the host families I met. Here's my first host family, and I'll never forget that night I threw those kids up in the air. Just to see the faces light up, awesome. My second host family, both Cesar and his wife and kids, to know their struggle and his long hours just to make everything work, I look up to him. And Adriana, without her, I don't know what we'd do without her. Her translations and everything, great help. And Raul, so much to say about him, and even though he didn't know a lick of English, he still wanted to play soccer, hang out with us, he even wanted to share a few beer and have a good time with us. Most of all, never forget you guys. Thank you for this experience and all the fun times I've had.
To be blind, pretending not to see their needs. A somebody's struggle, somebody's broken heart in a one man's soul. And they followed a pattern on a wind and know. And cause I got no place to go, that's why I want you to know. I'm starting with the man in your mirror, I'm asking him to change his ways. And no message could have been any clearer. If you want to make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and the main that change, change. Na na na, na na na, na na na, na na na. Oh no. I've been a victim of a selfish kind of love. It's time that I realize there was something known, and not a nickel too low. Could it be really me pretending that they're not alone? Oh, below deep blue sky, somebody's broken heart in a washed out dream. They followed a pattern on a wind, you see. And cause I got no place to be, that's why I'm starting with me. I'm starting with the man in the mirror, and I'm asking him to change his ways. And no message could have been any clearer. If you wanna make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and make that change.